Bottom line is, I've been doing this a long time. I know the question single ladies usually ask me. And, you know, one of the big things is, why doesn't he call back? And it was such a big deal. I remember some friends wrote a book called He's Just Not Into You, which is an overly simplified answer. For sure, sometimes men don't call back. But anybody who's been with somebody, had a great time, and then they don't call back or they lose interest, you go, what happened? It's such a, you kind of look at yourself, did I say this, did I do that? And just doesn't let go because there's no understanding. And so sometimes it is, you know, you meet someone and you find out they're not the right person for you. And sometimes women will say, well, why doesn't he just say I'm not the right person? And I say, are you kidding? Who wants to say that? And the bottom line in men is they want to make women happy. But that doesn't mean they want to make every woman happy. I mean, actually, they would like to make every woman happy, but they don't want to be in a relationship with every woman. And so what happens is when something's not working, not clicking, he's not going to tell you, generally speaking. He's just not going to call back. So that's one reason a guy doesn't call back. But there's so many other reasons. And it's very important to understand that. There's ways that she may have sabotaged the interaction. And so there is something she said or did that didn't inspire him to call back or to pursue the relationship. So that's clearly a possibility. And I'd like to talk today about some of those things that women commonly do that kind of turn men off. And then there's another aspect of masculinity, I guess I'll start with. And that's that we as men and women have a different biological system. And, you know, I'm presently working on a book actually called Beyond Stereotypes, because actually, if you've read Men Are From Mars, Women Are From Venus, nowhere in there do I imply or suggest that women can't do everything a man does and a man can't do everything a woman does. It's just that these are differences that show up in that process. So a lot of people have been critical of the work because they think I'm like fitting into old stereotypes. There's actually no stereotypes in my book that are the traditional stereotypes. It's just wisdom in terms of how men and women are biologically set up differently to react to happiness and stress, pain and pleasure. So men basically have a system, and this is building up to a very important thing, testosterone. Testosterone is this hormone that men need at least 10 times more than a woman to feel good. If he doesn't have his heavy, you know, a good level of testosterone, then he doesn't feel pleasure. He doesn't feel interest. He doesn't feel motivation. And that's what he feels so much in the beginning, is that all that interest the guy has and that attraction. On a biological level, that's testosterone. Now, it's not like you can just shoot him with testosterone and it happen. His body has to make it. So he's making this testosterone. It's the foundation of interest and romance and growing together. Okay, so if a man's testosterone level goes down, he's going to feel passive, irritable, grumpy. He can become judgmental. I mean, it's amazing how, as a man, I can shift from being, my God, she's the most beautiful woman in the world, to, oh, my gosh, she's got big toes. It's you know, just as women can be really hard on themselves, a guy can be really hard on women, and it's fleeting. For women, it's not so fleeting. They tend to hang on to these things. But a guy, it just testosterone goes up, you are beautiful. Testosterone goes down, he is like, I don't know, you know, I don't feel so good when I'm with her. Because testosterone gives men energy. It gives men aliveness. It gives men pleasure. So it's really important for women to understand this. If you learn how to create testosterone in a man, then you make sure you're not going to be sabotaging the relationship. So it's kind of like, why do men lose interest? Well, here's the bottom line, is to really understand testosterone, we need to do the flip side of that, a little bit about women. For women, it's estrogen. Estrogen have, generally speaking, 10 times more estrogen than a guy. Okay. Now, as guys get older and you get these overweight guys that aren't very motivated in life, you know, you can tell them they got a belly. I'm sorry, guys, but that's part of having a belly is estrogen. A little belly's fine. That means he's more in touch with his sensitivities. He's more compassionate. He's going to be more empathetic. There's certain challenges that come with estrogen in men. But a younger man, he's going to, you know, in his 30s and 40s and so forth, he's still got his testosterone at a healthy level. In order to feel good, he needs that testosterone. But when he connects with a woman and they spend a lot of time together and he's doing a lot of things to please her, what happens is his estrogen goes up. Okay, that's really key. Is sex with a guy afterwards, his testosterone levels tend to go down. Now, it's a subtlety. It's actually, his testosterone might be the same, but the amount of free testosterone goes down. But we'll just, for simplicity, say his testosterone goes down. And when that happens, he needs to pull away in order to rebuild his testosterone. So a guy theoretically can have a horrible time with a woman and not want to call her back. Or a guy could just be a doesn't fit and not want to call her back. Or it could be a guy that really likes her, has a good time, and they have sex. These female hormones get produced. A lot of oxytocin gets produced as well. And oxytocin is a hormone that will actually lower his testosterone. So oxytocin is the hormone that lowers stress in women. Oxytocin is the hormone of cuddling, of affection, of romance. It's also in there, of connection, of feeling love. So all those are strong feelings that come along with estrogen and oxytocin. But you get those two things together, which is what romance is, his testosterone levels will start to drop. Now, once they start to drop, he's feeling really, really good with you. But then suddenly he feels like, oh, I can't breathe. I need to get away. And when he starts to pull away, the mistake women can make is that they'll start asking him lots of questions. Like, let's talk about the relationship. Or why aren't you calling me back? And what's going on? And just keep this as a general rule. Whenever you feel like you need to ask a guy questions about a relationship, you're going to be pushing him away. If you really want to talk about your relationship, wait till you're feeling very connected and close and you're not feeling insecure. When you're looking for reassurance that there's some future here, it's usually because you're feeling him disconnecting. You're feeling he's pulling away. And rather than ask questions at that time, what you need to do as a woman is pull away yourself. That's where you have to practice detaching and finding something else in your life that brings you a greater sense of fulfillment and happiness, so that when he pulls away, he's like a rubber band. He pulls back, he'll get to a certain point where his testosterone levels will come up. Anytime a man is feeling independent or successful, his testosterone levels are going to start going up, up, up. That makes him feel horny. That makes him want to get close to a woman again to bring his testosterone down a little bit. So think of testosterone as like too low is moody and passive and irritable. Too high is a bit of it's a lot of pleasure when it goes up high, but then it becomes a little too agitated, like somebody who's taken a, you know, an upper. They want to take a downer. It's too stressful to his body when it stays too high for long. So he starts feeling restless, and the body says connect with a woman, and it will bring it back down to just the right point. Then he wants to come close to her. He comes into her. Then it will start to go down and he wants to pull away. So there's this dance. So the takeaway from this understanding is the realization that too much closeness can push a man away. And too many questions can push a guy away.